End of chapter 28, Piloting and Prophecy. Chapter 29, The End of Piloting. It is curious, however, that Madame Caprell, with clairvoyant vision, should not have seen an important event then scarcely more than 2 months distant. The breaking out of the Civil War, with the closing of the river and the end of Mark Twain's career as a pilot. Perhaps these things were so near as to be this side the range of second sight. There had been plenty of war talk, but few of the pilots believed that war was really coming. Traveling that great commercial highway, the river, with intercourse both of north and south, they did not believe that any political differences would be allowed to interfere with the nation's trade, or would be settled otherwise than on the street corners, in the halls of legislation, and at the polls. True, several states, including Louisiana, had declared the Union a failure and seceded, but the majority of opinions were not clear as to how far a state had rights in such a matter, or as to what the real meaning of secession might be. Comparatively few believed it meant war. Samuel Clemens had no such belief. His Madame Caprell letter bears date of February 6, 1861, yet contains no mention of war or of any special excitement in New Orleans, no forebodings as to national conditions. Such things came soon enough. President Lincoln was inaugurated on the 4th of March, and 6 weeks later Fort Sumter was fired upon. Men began to speak out then and to take sides. It was a momentous time in the association rooms. There were pilots who would go with the Union. There were others who would go with the Confederacy. Horace Bixby was one of the former, and in due time became chief of the Union River Service. Another pilot named Montgomery, Samuel Clemens had once steered for him, declared for the South, and later commanded the Confederate Mississippi Fleet. They were all good friends, and their discussions, though warm, were not always acrimonious, but they took sides.